Jacob Rees-Mogg defended his constituents, many of whom work in a North East Somerset à la rue factory, and outlined a plan for the government to help counter rival bids from a Franco-Dutch firm. The arch-Brexiteer said, "I will still have a passport, so wherever it is printed I will have to have it. My concern is a constituency concern because De La Rue has a factory in North East Somerset and I obviously want that factory to prosper and provide employment in North East Somerset. It is unfortunate that De La Rue's bid was £120 million higher than the bid by the Dutch and French consortium, and the government should perhaps go back to De La Rue and say, can you match the price that we are being offered? The government has to be careful with taxpayers' money." De La Rue believes it came ahead of its Franco-Dutch rival in the UK passport bid on both quality and security, and was undercut only on price. De La Rue told the Financial Times that it was taking the first steps towards initiating a judicial review in the High Court against the provisional decision to award the contract to the part state-owned company. Meanwhile, the Home Office extended the deadline for legal challenges until April 17 as De La Rue asked for more details about the circumstances under which the decision was made. Getty LBC Jacob Rees-Mogg was asked what action he will take if the De La Rue appeal fails. Peter Bone, Conservative MP for Wellingborough, said, "This is one of the reasons why we need to look at this contract again. We have a British company that provides passports the world over and does a first-class job, and the other company comes in with a significantly cheaper price. Has anyone thought, well, maybe they are doing that because the quality won't be as good, or they are trying to undercut? That's why I think it needs to be looked at again. And if there is evidence of previous contracts by this company where the quality has not been good enough, that's even more reason. Look at what happened with Carillion. They put in a silly price and it resulted in contracts not being done. Well, imagine if that were British passports. That would be unprecedented. It's right that we look again at the contract and make sure that it has been awarded not just on the cheapest price but what we want for the contract." At the time the decision was announced, Immigration Minister Caroline Notes told the House of Commons, "We had to look at quality, security and price, and this was the contract that provided the best value on all counts." However, De La Rue executives claim Gemellato won the contract, worth close to £400 million, purely as a result of undercutting rival bids. A De La Rue spokesman said, "Based on our knowledge of the market, it's our view that ours was the highest quality and technically most secure bid. In the light of this, we are confident that we remain the best and most secure option in the national interest."